Myself, Sandeep Javheri, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering from Walchand School of Technology, Solapur. In today's session, we are going to discuss methods of irrigation. The learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to explain various methods of irrigation. Now, before going to methods of irrigation, we must know what is irrigation. So, irrigation is a method of artificial application of water on the surface of ground. It may be by means of gravity or by means of pumping action, that is by lifting methods. So, let us discuss some methods of irrigation. There is a surface irrigation, subsurface irrigation, drip irrigation, and sprinkler irrigation. Surface irrigation, it is a group of application techniques where water is applied and distributed over the soil surface by means of gravity. So here there is no pumping action is required in case of surface irrigation. By means of gravity, the water is going to directly applied on the ground. Again, few types of surface irrigation are mentioned here, such as basin irrigation, border irrigation, furrow irrigation, and check flooding, etc. Let us discuss about basin irrigation. The most common form of irrigation, which is particularly applied in small fields. In India, such irrigation is very popular as it controls flooding process. This is applicable for small sized plots, which is practically leveled, and water is allowed to enter in higher end plots and water flows stops when it is reached at lower end of the plots. Especially, it is applicable for erodible soil. Now let us consider the typical sketch of this basin irrigation. Here, from the field channel, the water is going to be taken out into the field, and this field is having end bounded with a particular embankment or bund, so that when water enters and settle down into the soil mass, then it will not get expelled out because of the embankment. So it is most popular method for the rice. Soil mass is not eroded because the presence of embankment. Let us consider the border irrigation. It is most common form of irrigation, particularly in small fields. For close growing crops such as pasture or alfalfa are preferred for this type of irrigation. In this method, the farm is divided into a series of 10 to 20 meter wide and 100 meter to 300 meter long strips. Water is applied to each strip in controlled manner till water reaches lower end of strip. This is also a popular method of irrigation. Let us see this sketch. This is a plan view of border irrigation, in that the plots are divided into number of strips and they are separated by a small bund. You can see here clear picture. This is around 10 to 20 meter wide and about 100 to 300 meter long strip, and in between them there is a embankment, a small bund is present. So in this third sketch we can see from the main channel the water is entered into the plot, and this soil mass which are present here, it will not get eroded because of the presence of this embankment. So this method is also popular. Now furrow irrigation. It is the most common form of irrigation particularly in small fields for row crops. For example, if you consider maize, cotton, tobacco, groundnut, potatoes, sugarcane, such types of crop can be used for furrow irrigation. As compared to other methods, that is border irrigation or basin irrigation, the water savings are more in this method. The spacing between two furrows is 1 meter to 2 meter. Now this is a typical photograph of this furrow irrigation. Here the row crops are present here and they are spaced about 1 to 2 meter. This is also a popular method of irrigation. Check flooding. So in this method, large amount of water is discharged into a comparatively smaller pot surrounded by checks or levees. These levees are generally 2 to 3 meter wide at the base and 20 to 30 centimeter high. So in check flooding, we can control the discharge of water also, and this is also applicable for permeable soil. Now another method of irrigation is subsurface irrigation. If the soil mass is highly permeable and if the groundwater table is at high position, then subsurface irrigation is useful. Drip irrigation, it is also called trickle irrigation. As we know, the monsoon is going to be changed day by day. It is not fixed. So there may be some areas where the rainfall is very low. So in that case, we can go for drip irrigation. As in this method, water is directly applied in the form of drops near to the base of the plant. Water is distributed through the flexible pipes, which is operating at low pressures. Water is applied through the nozzles. So here the pipes diameter are vary from 10 centimeter to 20 centimeter. Now let us see the photograph of drip irrigation. Here the pipes are laid on the ground, and through these pipes the water is passed, and this water is going to be deposited in form of drops through the nozzles, which are near to the root of this crop. So direct usage of water is done in this drip irrigation. So loss of water is avoided, and also it saves water, as in the region where the rainfall is less. So this method is really helpful. So in Maharashtra and in many states, we go for drip irrigation because it saves lot of water. Sprinkler irrigation. Now in this type of irrigation, the water is going to be applied in terms of spray, like ordinary rain, like garden lawn spraying. This can be adopted in case of steep slopes and where is the chances of erosion of soil takes place. In such cases, we go for sprinkler irrigation. Sometimes the topography is not regular, so such irrigation is useful. And mostly, this sprinkler irrigation is useful for vegetable crops or fruit crops. You can see, this is a jet. And through this jet, the water is going to be sprayed all over the crops. So for this, pumping is required. Since initial cost is more, and also, so to operate this equipment, special labors are required. So it is costly. Now you are supposed to pause the video and answer these questions. Now these are the answers. As we know, the irrigation method providing the water directly at root zone. So for this, the correct option is drip irrigation, because for sprinkler irrigation, it is not possible to put a water directly to the root zone, because spraying water action is done here. Furrow is also not possible, flooding is also not possible. So drip irrigation is the correct option for this. Now second question is, sprinkler irrigation is best suitable for vegetable and fruit crops. You know, these are the references which we are using for the creation of this video. Thank you.